Hello everybody and welcome back to Simulate Gaming and welcome to a brand new adventure here on Sandy Bay 17. I cannot wait for this series. I've been looking forward to this for a long, long time now. Oh, look at that plane. And finally we can get to it. Now, just before we get going, I am playing this series a lot different to the rest of my series. So this one we're going for a corporate style. So basically everyone seems to start at the bottom with small old equipment and then they work their way up. In this, we're going to be basically playing it as if we're a chain farm and we're trying to get as much land around the area as we can and do different crops and that good stuff. It should be fun. We've also got seasons mod installed, so of course we have to take into consideration what season it is. So at the moment it is spring and all of our fields are planted that we own, so we need to go ahead and fertilize them. That's the only thing we've got to do today. So that involves driving down to the store and collecting some pallets, bring them back, and doing some fertilizing in something that I think you're going to enjoy. So stay tuned for that. Okay, so like I just said, we're taking this series ultra, ultra realistic. So I'm gonna step up the game a little bit, and we're going to go to game extension, and we're going to go tabbing into vehicles off. So we can no longer tab into vehicles, as you might be able to hear in the background. So that's why we have this pickup truck, so we can actually drive around to all the different things that we need. This was a last-minute thought, so yeah. First of all, we're going to jump into this today then. I'll give our head tracking a reset. I don't like the interior of this thing, so we're going to drive in third person. And then we'll head down to our first piece of equipment that we're going to be using. So like I said, we are going for the corporate style. So hopefully the vehicles and stuff that I've chosen do suit that. Now, just because I'm said I'm playing ultra realistic, or trying to play ultra realistic, doesn't mean I know everything. I'm not saying I know everything, so if you can give me tips and advice, then that'd be very, very grateful. So what we're going to do is back up the pickup truck. We'll just leave it like here somewhere. Nice and safe. Awesome. So the first vehicle we're driving here on Sandy Bay, apart from the pickup truck, is our man truck. Now, yes, we have individual trucks here. So we've got this one, which we're going to be using for our bale stacking. We have this Tatra here that we're using to grain cart. And we have an auger wagon somewhere, so that's how we're going to be actually doing it on the field and dumping it into the Tatra. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. It's like a little bit different from me anyway. So yeah, let's get into it. So we're going to go ahead and jump into the man. We're going to take only half of this, because you can see they're actually connected to each other. We don't need the back half today, so we're just going to take the front. And we do not need a loader either, because the store actually has one that we can use, which is nice. So we'll jump in to the man. Did I disconnect it? I don't think I did. There we go. So yes, I actually nearly accidentally brought that with us then. So there is our combines over there. I'll show you them in a later episode. I'll just show you things as we drive past. I'm not going to bother giving you a little tour, but I'll show you the things as we pass. We've got the Bergman forage wagon. The reason I got the Bergman is just to make it a little bit different to all my other series. We've got the brand new Kuhn disc cultivator there with the seed drills that plants, I believe, oilseed radish, I think it was. That's that red thing up there is the auger wagon I was telling you guys about. Cool. So anyway, yes, welcome back to Sandy Bay. I say welcome back. I didn't actually ever do a series on Sandy Bay. That was before my time. I started, when my YouTube channel came out, Thornton Farm was pretty much out, so I didn't bother doing a series on Sandy Bay. But I did watch other YouTubers like Banky and all that good stuff playing theirs. So yeah, I do enjoy it. Let's just reset this. There we go. See a little bit better now. So we're head. Actually, we should probably do that before we go. We need to collect some fertilizer pallets. We can get the fertilizer tank. Well, that's a liquid one. Yeah, we're going to use this one actually, because we're doing some spraying today. And like I said, I think you guys are going to enjoy what we have. I hope so. Anyway. Now, if you can notice a difference in my voice, by the way, I should mention that I broke my microphone. So that's why there's not been any videos up since the live stream, because I was trying to set up for the day after that, which was Saturday, so Sunday I was setting up to record, and they snapped my microphone boom thing. So that's unfortunate. So we're using a backup microphone now, so hopefully the quality is okay. Just turn into the store here. So yeah, big corporate farms, not really corporate farms, but big farms, they tend to use trucks around me, and this is based in Devon, so I thought, why the heck not? This would be a perfect map to do this. So there's our pallets. We'll quickly maneuver this around like that. There's the forklift I was telling you guys about. Go ahead and turn her off to save on some diesel. We'll jump in to the forklift. I don't think you could open the door from the outside. No, you can't. We could do it from in here, though. There we go. Get some air in here. This should work with the joystick. Yes, it does. Cool. So for those of you that haven't seen... Oh, gosh, we're stuck in something. That's the pilot camera. I didn't realise I had that. So for those of you who haven't seen this before, you probably have because it's on the mod hub, but some people say this forklift's too big. That's not actually true. This style of forklift is actually quite scaled and realistic to what it gets used for. This is usually found in, like, quarries and dockyards and stuff where it's heavy-duty stuff as opposed to just picking up a couple of pallets. What is that black thing that keeps popping in the way? That's not meant to happen, I don't think. It's kind of getting in the way. So let's go ahead and try that again. We're not going to bother using the pallet cam because it's just getting in the way. Right. Let's do our best here. I'm going to rotate the camera around. Now we can go... Actually, can you guys see that on camera? We can, if we twist the joystick, make the forks go in and out, which is pretty cool. Once again, this is on the mod hub, in-game mod hub, if you want this. And we'll pick this one up here. And we'll get it loaded on to our truck. Now, hopefully I can get all these on. I've only got four. Four should be more than enough for what we need today. I'm not going to bother doing too much of this because you can buy the fertilizer in the yard as well, which we might do. Right, let's get this loaded up. Now, the only bad thing about this forklift is we can't extend the boom, so we can't put it on the back of the trailer. We'll have to push it on with the other pallet. So let's drop this one here for now. There we go. Double-click that somehow. Reverse out of there. Cool. So like I just said, we'll need to get another pallet now to push that one over to the back. Which one are we going to go for? That's the question. Here we go. So this microphone's right in the way of my eye, so I'm technically playing this with one eye. So if I'm a bit off today, I do apologise. My new microphone is on the way. I had a notification from the shop where I purchased it from. Hopefully it will make me sound a bit better than the last one that's just broken, actually. I've been needing to get a new one for ages. But I didn't want to leave you guys for too long, so I've come up with a backup plan. So hopefully it doesn't sound too bad. Theoretically, it should sound better because it's a more expensive microphone, but... this one's got a very small range on it, so if I move my head too far that way, then you probably won't be able to hear me. So I've got to try avoid doing that at all costs. And I can't see. Bad visibility on this forklift, I must admit. Let's zoom out a little bit. We'll go into here. Straighten this out. Oh gosh, we got a little bit higher here. Lower it down like that. You gonna behave? Yes. No. No, you're not. Once, I'd just like these forklifts to behave. Just once. Please. Oh. Yes. There we go. So there's the first two on. Go ahead and collect the second two. Now, like I said, you're probably going to be able to tell from the thumbnail, actually, because more than likely, I'll make it the thumbnail, but... we are using quite an interesting sprayer today. It was converted by a friend of mine, Pedro Chaps, who's also working on a map. A really good looking map, actually. He's also the guy that made the Rusty Ford, whatever the model is. The one that's in-game. The New Holland, but the Ford version. He's the guy who made the Rusty version of that as well. Cool. So yes, not only are we using... oh god, I just hit that. Not only are we using a special sprayer, we're also using something quite cool that goes with it, and it's also made by Pedro Chaps. This is basically the Pedro Chaps episode today, as soon as we get these loaded up though. Go ahead and lower that down. Back up here. Stay. Whoa. Maybe I should bring the forks in just a little bit more here. Oh gosh, I forgot we turned that. I've got to go at a different angle. Let's go in this way. Right, so there's our final pallet loaded up there. Let's go ahead and retract the arm in. It's a little bit wonky, but the best we can do. The reason the black thing keeps popping over the camera is because there's a bit of a delay between the forks moving and the actual boom itself. That's why we're getting that weird bit of black there. Right. Let's rotate this final pallet on here. Come on, get on. Yes. Right, that should do it. We'll lower it all the way down here. Stay. No, get back up. There we go. We'll try that again, shall we? There we go. So I'm going to quickly take this, forklift. I'll take the forklift back. Leave it here. We'll lower that down for health and safety reasons. Turn the beacon off. That light down there, by the way, is the beacon, so when it's on, obviously the beacons are on. Turn it off. And we're done. That door should be closing. Yes, it is. Right, so just before we head up, of course, we are going to put our straps on. Just so we don't lose our expensive fertilizer tanks. That will be quite an expensive accident for us. Cool. So you just see me drive down here, and you've just seen me load all these up. So we don't waste any more time on this episode. I will meet you guys back at the, God, open up. Well, there's the snake. I think Landy Kid called it Boris, I think it was. There's Landy's snake there. So yeah, we're going to go ahead and take this back up, and I'll meet you guys back at the farm. Right, everybody, so we're just coming back up towards Sandy Bay Farm now. Now, for those of you that didn't play on this map on Farm Sim 15, this actually used to be Willow Farm, but Oxygen David, the creator of the map, swapped them around for whatever reason, but I kind of like that, because I actually prefer this farm anyway. We are stuck on something. Put four-wheel drive on, because of course this is the four-wheel drive version. Well, we've got four wheels at the back, I should say. All right, so we'll quickly move this somewhere useful. I think that's going to be right here, because we need to get into that shed there. Let's go ahead and turn her off, save on some diesel. Right, so I'm going to show you guys the telehandler we bought. Now, it's a little bit different to my usual style. I've never actually used this, although it was in 15. So we have the JCB, no idea what the model number is. The TM320S. Actually, we've already got the pallet fork attached, which is quite handy. So these are our attachments. This is our telehandler, only because I've not used it before, so I wanted to try something a little bit different. We've got the CSZ, I think it is, pallet fork. We've got the Kerfab by Black Sheep Modding, which of course I have in all my Let's Plays. It's a fantastic fork, and if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And we've also got this little beast, which is what we're going to be using to collect the bales once already stacked. It's like, I think you pick two up at a time with that. So that's all stuff to look forward to. But for now, we'll jump in to the telehandler. Now, as you can see, I don't actually need the map. As you can see, it is the first day of spring here on Sandy Bay. So I've got it set to 6 days per season, so it goes up to the sixth day of spring, and then it switches over to summer, and then 6 days of summer. You get the idea. So that's essentially what's going on. Now, this should be interesting. A learning curve for me, and maybe for you guys if you've never used it as well, because this is obviously a telehandler, but it's articulated. So it's going to be a bit of a learning curve. Right, now I'm going to show you guys the fertilizer spreader we're using today, which you probably already know because you've seen the thumbnail. Open up. Oh yeah, these are our tractors actually. I'll show you all of our tractors. I've completely forgot you guys like to see what tractors we're using. So I've got three on this farm so far. We've got the JCB Fast Track 3000, so it's never actually used the 3000 in any of my Let's Plays, so this should be different. Now this is a fictional one, and I will explain later why it's fictional. It's got custom number plates there, look. It's quite nice. We've got the John Deere 6M. I wanted the 6R, but it was a little bit too big for the farm, so I've gone ahead and got the M instead. And due to high demand, we have the Vultra. I don't actually personally like Vultras, but it is a fantastic looking tractor, and that's what you guys wanted to see on my Let's Plays, so we've gone ahead and done that. Not sure what model this is, because this is a modified version. Apparently the interior and all stuff lights up, which is quite cool. But today, we are using the Fast Track. Now, first of all, it's got the Nokian tyres on. I'm hoping I'm saying that correctly. It might be Nokian. No idea how to say it. But we've got these on just because it's a good little karting tractor, this. We won't be on the field much with this because we've got these two tractors here for that. We have got another tractor coming to the farm, but unfortunately it's not been delivered just yet. So hopefully the next couple of episodes we should have that. Actually, up here we've got the simulate license plate on the back as well. Custom simulate plates. I am going to try and get a simulate plate on all the ones that accept it, which is not any of these tractors. Oh, actually, there is a license plate thing on here at the top, so I may put it on that as well. But anyway, let's not waste any time. I'll show you guys what we're doing today. So, don't need four-wheel drive on. Actually, I'll show you guys why I said this was a fictional JCB, because some of you are probably wondering what the heck I'm talking about. If I press Control Y, this is actually four-wheel steering. And we took this off the 4000 series, but the 4000 is a hot mess, so we just put it on the 3000 instead. This is made, once again, by Pedro Chaps, and if he wants me to release it, I will. But of course it's up to him, because he's the guy who made it. And technically we're allowed, because this is just a Giants model, an edit of the Giants model. But anyway, let's go ahead and collect our fertilizer sprayers. So here they are. These are the... What make are these? I completely forgot. Let's have a look here. These are the Landquip fertilizer spreaders. Now these are... I don't know if they're built for the JCB 3000, but they fit. So that's what we're using today. So this back one here, as you can tell, is on stilts. We should theoretically be able to drive our tractor underneath here and use this as a sprayer. So we've got the four-wheel steering to help us turn at the end of the fields. We've got a fantastic little sprayer. All right, let's go ahead and reverse that under. Attach that on. And we're good to go. We're also glitched out into the wall by the look of it, which is annoying. Am I going to be able to save this or not? Let's just quickly use the keyboard. It's a little easier for this. Right, so we're glitching into the wall. So I'll go ahead and fix this, and I'll see you guys in a second. Right, okay, so the game unfortunately bugged out. Seasons sometimes conflicts with the fast-forward mod, and it's now 6:15, and it was just 8 o'clock in the morning, so we haven't got long left, unfortunately. Very annoying, so I've had to put it on to times one. But oh well. What are we going to do? So what we need to do right now is we'll unload one of these tanks. Maybe we can get two. Who knows? Because we've got both tanks there. And we'll load up. Now, unfortunately, there's not a realistic way of putting this in. So we have to just literally put it next to it and then press R. Which we could technically drive next to the truck. But we'll make it a little bit realistic here. So if I show you the weather forecast, today is Tuesday, so it's just cloudy. Wednesday sunny, Thursday is sunny, Friday's raining, so we'll have to try and get all of our fertilizing done by Friday. Saturday and Sunday, well, definitely Saturday, maybe Sunday, the soil is going to be very, very wet, so we may not be able to do anything on there either. So that's sort of the realism you have to think about with the Seasons mod. It does completely take over the game, which is a fantastic thing, I personally think. Right, let's go ahead and collect this first one here. It's sort of hooked onto it, even though I'm not actually hooked onto it. That's a bit unrealistic, but I'm not sure why that's happened, actually. I'm not even touching it. Why is that happening? There we go. Got it off. So it just magically clipped in somehow. Let's go ahead and zoom in onto the fork like that. See if we can... Actually, we may be able to fill this up. Depends if Pedro has put a trigger above the Landquip. Maybe not, but we'll soon find out. Oh, it is working. Okay, cool. So it just uses the normal unload strip by look of it. So obviously that's not how you'd fill this up in real life, but it's working. So we'll go ahead and stick to this for now. So there's one. 79% in there, so we may be able to get a little bit more in. I'm not sure if that's going into the front as well. That may just be the back tank. So we'll have to do a little check in a second. So actually, I'll show you why I'm doing the fertilizing today for our first episode. You may be wondering why we're not doing any harvesting. So all the fields that come with crops on them, as you can see here, are currently growing. Because the Seasons mod takes over, all the fields that Auction David put down aren't actually grown, even if Auction David told it to, because as soon as we start the game, all the crops get reset. So the game thinks we've only just planted them. So we're going to go ahead and fertilize them. Because I don't think they're fertilized out of the box. So this is going to be number one. Of course, we have to plow them three times, but I'm not sure we're going to be able to do that, first of all, because it's already growing. We'll have to, obviously, realistically, put it into the soil first. So this is going to be our only chance to fertilize, I believe. Right. Okay, let's go ahead and fill up the rest of this JCB now then. Like so. If I'm honest, I'm not really digging the articulated telehandler. Now, are we going to be able to put this in the front tank, or has it done it? Does it spread it out for us? We'll soon find out. Okay, it is. We are doing both tanks separately, which is pretty cool. So it's on 99% now. We're not going to bother unloading another one just for a 1%. So we'll go ahead and turn this off, and we're finally ready to begin today's video. So unfortunately, like I said, we've lost a lot of hours because of a glitch. But not to worry, the fill level's not actually working on this thing. That's meant to tell us how much is in there. But of course, we can just see down the bottom anyway. So what field are we going to first of all? Number 11. What's in field number 11? Okay, so field number 11 is wheat, and I'm pretty sure there's going to be more gates to that field, but I'm just going to play it safe and do the gates that used to be in Farm Sim 15. Actually, unless there's one along here, should we find out? It looks like there might be a gate down here. We'll check this way anyway. If not, we'll go around the back, because I remember there used to be one around the back to get into here. Is that a gate? Yes, it is. Cool, we're going to go ahead and use this gate then. Let's quickly stop the tractor here. We'll open the gate. So as you can't really tell because it's growing, but it's seeded. Wheat growth is on 0%. So we'll quickly get in here and fertilize this down. I should have put the narrow tires on this. This JCB does have narrow tires, but I don't yet have a workshop, unfortunately. So we're going to have to make do for now, and I'll do it in the next episode. Let's go get our beacons off. How are we going to start this? I think we'll start on this side of the field here, because it's straight. Let's go ahead and swing around like this. Get GPS out. All the way. Cool. Okay, so we're ready to go. Let's go ahead and unfold the sprayer. As you can see, it is working. We can actually lower it down as well like that. Next, we'll do, I think it's Control Y, I think Petrol said it to. Yeah, four-wheel steering is on. You can't, the back wheel's not as dramatic, but that's, of course, how it is in real life as well. Activate GPS. That is the Green Star mod you can hear, by the way. And we'll begin fertilizing if I turn it on. And we're away. So we're fertilizing this field here. This is field number 11. This is wheat. So yeah, a bit of a random episode to begin with, but of course we're just warming up. We're doing all the jobs that we actually have available before we can start making all the jobs what we want to make them. So we're sort of restricted at the moment, as we are when we start any map. But I've gone ahead and swapped out all the equipment and implemented some fun mods just to make it a little bit more interesting for you guys to watch. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. And we could probably do with getting some lights on, actually. I did have work lights. I can't remember which one. There's the back. I don't think I mapped out the front. I don't really need the front. So whilst we're here, a big thank you to Pedro if he's watching this, because I actually started doing the land quip myself. I got it working in-game I got it working in-game without any errors, but the actual spraying part didn't work, and then I had to go away for work. So I came back from the weekend at work, and Pedro had fixed it. So big thank you to Pedro, and also big thank you for the custom JCB. So the number plates and stuff was actually done by him. He did all the hard work with the four-wheel steering as well. So yeah, once again, big thank you to Pedro if he's watching this. And like I said as well, it's not up to me if I release this or not. It's up to Pedro. If he says I can release it, then I'll release it. If not, then you have to nag him instead. It's nothing to do with me. Right, let's go ahead and get GPS off here. Now I actually learned, someone told me in one of my previous videos, that we should do the headland first, because apparently it saves... It basically saves you some fertilizers. You're not wasting as much because, of course, you don't go up as far. which is a good shout, and I've only just remembered that actually, so I probably should have done that first, but not to worry. Right, okay, we're back. That was quite a good one. This map makes it so easy for YouTubers to get thumbnails, because you've got that fantastic scenery in the background there with the lighthouse and stuff. Really do love this map. This is my favourite map. I'm not just being biased, because this is Devon and I'm from Devon. It's just a fantastic map. It's just a coincidence that it happens to be Devon. I keep going to look back, and you can't actually see anything back there, because we've got this huge tank behind us. So, on the to-do list is to get row crop tires for this, and I have a way of getting a workshop, which is quite useful, so we'll go ahead and get that, so we can just basically use a workshop wherever we want to. So that's on the to-do list off-camera, and then on-camera we'll go ahead and get some row crops for this. I have had a couple of comments saying that I'm not using enough for the Coon DLC. I do apologise, I have got some Coon stuff on here, including the balers and stuff. So you will be seeing a lot more Coon in this series. I do apologise once again. Right, let's go ahead and take that to there. Awesome. So, we don't have any animals just yet. That's what we're building up for. So you may be thinking, why have you got loads of good equipment? You've got nothing to work up for now. That's our work up for. We're trying to save up for animals and stuff now. Also, we want to buy as much fields as we can. Because like I said, this is going to be a corporate farm. So we're going to have a lot of course play. We've got to do it all in a certain time frame, so it's going to be quite interesting. It's going to be a lot of hard work, and it may get a little bit repetitive sometimes, but at least it'll be realistic. And once again, I'm not an expert by any means, so if I'm doing something wrong, please tell me in a nice way in the comments, and I'll go ahead and take that advice on board. And I should have been doing the headland. I know that. I should have been doing the headland. I completely forgot. Now, you may just be able to see in the right hand side of the wheel cam there, it's a little DJ mixer. That's because, like I said at the beginning, my microphone broke, so I'm currently using my spare one, which is a XLR, not a USB. So I've got, as you can see in the background as well, actually, I've got cables going everywhere. Now the only benefit of this is I can make my voice go funky, so if I press this button here,
all of a sudden I sound like the Terminator or something, so
we can have some fun in live streams. Looking forward to using this in the live stream. My new microphone should be here soon, like I said, which won't have all those features. So I may just do a one-off live stream with the mixer. It should be quite fun. Okay, let's go into what's probably our second to last pass here. We're not going to need much of a headland on this. In fact, I don't think we need a headland at all, because we are managing to go right to the edges, because there is quite a bit of a natural headland on this field, or grass headland on this field. Right, so to come towards the end of this pass now, we are going to do a headland, because it's not worth turning around just for that little bit there. So we're just going to go ahead, get to about here, we'll turn the GPS off, and we'll just go do a headland. So like I said a second ago, I should have done this first, I am aware of that, but I'm a derp head, so I didn't. Also, good news for the people that have been, there's been a lot of people asking me to do the Let's Play with Fahi and Rainbow Dave again, so we have been in talks with that. So if you did enjoy that series back in the day, then you may be glad to know there is possibly a season 2 coming out, which is going to take place on a map that is kind of new to the channel, but I have been on it once, as a little clue for you. I have actually announced it in the live stream, so you can go back and watch that if you really want to know. Or you can just make it a surprise. So we need to do, before we go ahead and say it's definitely happening, we need to talk about details and stuff, and like what times we're recording, because we could have completely different schedules, which is going to make it a little bit hard. But yeah, I'm looking forward to that. It's should be quite a little interesting Let's Play. A lot of people still ask me to play old streams. That's not going to happen, unfortunately, because there's already a lot of people playing old streams, and I of course did a series on old streams back in Farm Sim 15, so I'm not really that tempted to go back, if I'm honest. It was a fantastic map, but I don't think I've got enough in me to play it again. Now, I have some surprises about this map, which I'm still testing currently. Plus, I'm waiting for Auction David to see if he's going to release any updates in the next couple of days. But I can promise you that if you did watch my old streams Let's Play on Farm Sim 15, you know that it was very different to everybody else's because I did some stuff to it. That's your clue. I've also done the same to this one, which should be interesting if I can get it all working. With the help of Shy Wizard, I might need to call in his expertise at some point. But yes, I can promise you that it will be a little bit different. So we're just coming up towards the last piece here. And we'll see how well we can do this. It's not going down very fast, actually, this fertilizer. I'm wondering if the usage is a little bit messed up. I may have to look in the XML. Maybe Pedro's done it on purpose? I don't know. But it just doesn't seem to be going down very quick. Have we got any in the front tank? I think they're both combined, but we do have some in the front tank at least. Right, so we're literally coming up towards the end here now. Like I said, it is a shame that the time messed up, because I wanted to have the sun in the background when we come around here, but at least we're doing some nice little sunset work here. Off camera, I think I'm going to do the other field, because I don't want episode number 2 to be exactly the same as episode number 1, because that will get the series off to a bad start. Also, I apologise if my voice has been quite annoying in this. One, I've got a different microphone, so I'm probably sounding a bit different. There might be a little bit of pops and stuff. But also, my voice is completely messed up. It's hurting so much just to speak, but I wanted to get a video out for you guys anyway. Guys and girls, according to my analytics. Right. So we're just going to carry on going down here, actually. I know we've already done this piece. Let's go ahead and get it turned off, folded away. In fact, we actually need to lift her up as well. Let's go ahead and do that now. Lift her all the way up to the top. We'll get our beacon lights on, work lights off, and we are done. So that's field number 11 fertilized and ready. Now we just got to wait for it to grow back. See if there's any cars coming. Hopefully the traffic on this map isn't like it is on Cobra Pot Farm. Love Cobra Pot Farm. Hate the traffic. Whoa. You just made me crash. Why does traffic just ignore us lately? It used to stop a lot further down than that. But yes, anyway, thank you for joining me in this episode on Sandy Bay, episode number 1. Once again, sorry it wasn't that interesting. Of course, we can only do what we've got available to us now. Apparently there's a fish in there, actually. Should we see if we can find it? Hey, fishy fish. Oh, there he is. Found him straight away. Hello, fish. There's the fish. Right. See, once again, sorry it may be a little bit boring for you, but we just got to wait until we can get the farm into a position that we actually like. I'm just going to leave all these tanks on for now because I need to do some more fields off camera. So if you did enjoy, please hit my thumbs up button. It really does mean a lot. Hit subscribe to see more for myself. I've been Simulate Gaming, and I'll see you in the next one.